question generalized, the formalism we have developed in the last class. Last class was for 2D space, a curved 2D space. Now today we are dealing with a curved ND space. Say, a curved ND space is specified by N coordinates x1, x2, up to xn. Now, a small displacement dr at point P is given by the coordinate changes dx mu. A small displacement dr, it has components. How many components will be there? Because the space is n-dimensional, there will be n coordinate changes. So, we write the coordinate changes dx mu superscript. Mu runs from 1 to up to n. Now, this displacement has length, of course, and that length we define by ds square, the square length square, the thing you have seen before I have talked about. And this is given by mu summation mu 1 to n, summation mu 1 to n, g mu nu bracket p. P means here, the g mu nu has to be evaluated at the point P. Multiplied by dx nu, dx nu. So this is the length squared in nd space, not for 2D space. You can generalize, you can minimize the space to 2 and the same thing will be applied. Okay, now g mu nu, g mu nu as a whole would n square at n square components constitute the metric tensor at P. G mu nu is a metric tensor at the point P, and it has n square components. But G has to be g nu mu symmetric. So how many components will remain there? Independent components. So g mu nu has n into n minus 1 divided by 2 independent components. While about symmetry is applied, diminute nemo, then in the example given in the last class, you have seen that we have only three things, S square, D square, and B. These were 2D space, but three independent components were there. Only three independent coordinates were there. S square, D square, and P. So the space was two-dimensional, 2 factorial, multiplied by 2 minus 1, that is 1 factorial, 2 factorial, and n is 2 multiplied by 2. The space was 2 by 2. Space was 2 by 2. How many independent components? N into n plus 1. Yes, n into n plus 1. 2 multiplied by 3, 6 divided by 2, 3. 3 components, independent components will be there for 2D space. Now, a Small displacement is not the only coordinate change. A small displacement is not the only vector or entity in a point P. There will be other vectors. There will be other finite vectors. For finite vectors also, we should define the vector Utkatrabhujan components. We should define Utkatrabhujan components. And the squared length, say a vector is V. The squared length is V vector mod square is given by mu nu g mu nu u v mu v. This is the squared length of the vector V, same as the before expression. Now, scalar product of U and V. U vector dot V vector is equals sum over mu, sum over nu, G mu nu, U mu V mu. This is the scalar product of two vectors U and V. Now comes the summation convention. You see, we have many expressions, and for every expression, you have to write these two sums. It is cumbersome. This is cumbersome. So we inherit it from Einstein. Einstein proposed a summation convention. What is that? If in a term a particular affix comes both as superfix and suffix, has to be summed up. Okay? In that case, summation convention. U dot V equals G mu nu, U mu V nu. No summation sign is written. Mu comes as subscript once, superscript one. So this should be summed. Nu comes once as a subscript, as a superscript one. So nu has to be summed. Though the sum is already done. So this is your summation convention. Now, there is another kind of vector. We have already talking about contrapedian. Usually a vector is given by the contrapedian components. But we have another type of vectors which are called covariant vectors. And covariant vectors are defined by covariant vectors. Covariant vectors are defined by V mu, see the affix is in the lower, it is a subscript. Whenever it is a covariant vector, the affix will be as a subscript. V mu, and it has to be found out from nu equals 1 to n g mu nu equal p p mu. You see, in the on the left hand side, this is p mu, it is called covariant. Right hand side, it is p mu, it is contravariant. From a contravariant, the index is upper, you have to go to covariant, the index is lower. In between, you have to do a summation with that metric tensor. This is equivalent to be written as G mu nu we knew. With the summation convention, you don't have to write the summation. New comes twice. Here is superscript, here is subscript. New sum, or new remains. So this will be new. Okay, this is the coherent components. Now, what summation convention says? Summation convention says whenever there are two affixes and one comes as superscript, one as subscript, you have to sum that. You have to sum over that index. And if there is a lone index, that means comes only once, as a superscript or a subscript, but comes only once. If an index comes for only once, you have to take all the values of that component. That means you will have a series of terms, one for each of the entry of that index. So, understood this?
Yes.
Okay. Now, we have from covariant to covariant done. Now we want to know from covariant to contravariant. It is called raising an index. Beforehand it was lowering an index. Now it will be raising an index. So you see, this is given by B mu, is given by G mu nu V mu. What is G mu nu? We'll talk about. Here is B nu, nu nu sums. What is mu? Here is mu, V mu. Now, G mu nu is inverse of G. G mu nu is inverse of G mu nu. Or if G mu nu is a matrix and you call it G, then G mu nu, the matrix will be G inverse. And whenever you multiply these two, G mu nu, G mu nu, you will get, say here it is alpha, it is alpha, this is nu. G mu alpha, mu nu alpha, you will get what? Alpha will sum over, you will get delta mu nu. G mu alpha multiplied by G nu alpha will be delta mu nu. Delta mu nu is usual quantified delta. When mu is nu, it is 1. When mu is not nu, it is 0. Okay. Also, G and G inverse are their independence. G inverse and G multiplied will give you a unit matrix. So, G mu nu and G mu nu once has both superscript, it is called contravariant metric. This is called covariant metric. And delta mu nu is called mixed metric. There are three metrics. This is contravariant metric, this is covariant metric, this is mixed metric. And for this reason, there are three expressions for a scalar product. There are three expressions for scalar product. U dot V equals G mu nu U mu V nu, or G mu nu G mu nu U mu V nu. Or delta mu nu U mu V nu. The three expressions for the scalar product U dot V. The three expressions for the scalar product U dot V. For because there are three types of metric tons of diminutive. So students, electricity has gone out while blanked out. So to the dispatch, in the next class, we'll talk about geodesics, which is the most central concept of general relativity, geodesic. In the next class, inshallah, we shall talk about geodesic and the patterns. Thank you very much.